So children, this is the continuation video of the poem Abu Bin Adham. Here I will explain each line of the poem. Before that, I'll tell you a brief summary. I tell everyone to keep your poem short stories book, open the page, keep one pencil and also one copy you keep with you, so that when I explain the lines, you can write the meaning of the lines, difficult word or phrase or lines, if I say, because those explanations will certainly help you to write the answers of your workbook as well as the answers of any question comes from this chapter, this poem. So let's read the summary first. Abu Bin Adham is sleeping peacefully. He wakes up and sees an angel writing something in a book. The angel is writing the names of people who love God. Abu inquires and is told that his name is not there on the list. Abu requests the angel to put his name in the list of people who love their fellow men. The angel does so and vanishes. The next day, the angel reappears and shows Abu the names of people who have been blessed by God. Abu is pleasantly surprised to see that his name at the top of the list. Now, I will start the lines. Now, children, this poem, poet has made two stanzas. But for the easier process of explanation, I made it four parts. First three parts are the first stanza and the last part is the second stanza of the poem. So let me start with the first part of the poem. Abu bin Adham, may his tribe increase, awoke one night from a deep dream of peace and saw within the moonlight in his room, making it rich and like a lily in bloom. So, Abu bin Adham was a virtuous man who did good to everybody. Hence, the poet praises and blesses him. And he wishes that there should be more good people like him. So, here you have to understand the line what he says in the first line, may his tribe increase. The meaning of that is that the poet wishes that there should be more good people like him. Now let's see the second line. Awoke one night from a deep dream of peace. So one night he was sleeping and dreaming peacefully when he suddenly woke up. Now, and saw within the moonlight in his room, making it rich and like a lily in bloom, and saw within the moonlight in his room. So Abu's room was lit by the light of moon. This image conveys a feeling of beauty, stillness and tranquility. And in that moonlight, he saw something. What he saw? See the next line. Though I will explain the whole part next. But this line you just see, an angel writing in a book of gold. So what he saw? He saw an angel writing something in a book made of gold. So this book of gold symbolizes the richness of people who love God. Because when you love God, your soul becomes rich. Now, coming back to the third and fourth line especially, making it rich and like a lily in bloom. So, the presence of the angel meant the atmosphere of the room rich with its divine beauty, just like the beauty of a blooming lily flower. Poet uses lily flower as a simile because lily is symbolic of devotion and holiness. Lily in bloom. This conveys the saintliness of the angel which is felt by Abbeu. And Abbeu too was a saintly person. Coming to the next lines. This angel writing in a book of gold, I already said. Now see the next line. Exceeding peace had made Ben Adhem bold. And to the presence in the room he said, "What writest thou?" The vision raised its head, and with a look made of all sweet accord. So, what it is said in the second line of this second part, exceeding peace had made Ben Adhem bold. So, since Ben Adhem was a good man, he always acted rightly. He had nothing to fear. It is written the bold. So, he had nothing to fear. He had peace with himself. So, without hesitation, he asked the angel. It is written, and to the presence, this presence is indicated to angel. Asked the angel, "What writest thou?" That means, what are you writing? Now see children, the poet uses the what presence to convey the spiritual aspect of the angel. The angel was after all not a physical being, but an energy, a divine presence that was being perceived by Abbeu. Next see, the vision raised its head and with a look made of all sweet accord. Vision raised its head. The vision refers to the angel. The poet uses the word vision to convey that probably only Abbeu could see him because Abbeu was a good man. And the angel wanted Abbeu to be able to see him. So understood this line, the vision raised its head, then and with a look made of all sweet accord. What is the meaning of sweet accord? Sweet accord means a sweet, gentle look of complaints. That means here what, so the angel what raised its head and Abbeu replied. Angel raised its head at Abbeu and replied something. So that we will get to know in the next part of the poem. So see the next line of the third part. Answered the names of those who love the Lord and is mine, said Abbeu. Nay, not so, replied the angel. Abbeu spoke more low, but cheerily still, and said, I pray thee then, write me as one that loves his fellow men. So, Abbeu asked the angel. First when Abbeu asked what that she was writing, it was writing. Then that angel, that vision raised its head that I explained to you. And then with a like sweet chord, it is the meaning also I said, a sweet gentle look was there. And said that I am writing the names. It is written, answered the names of those who love the Lord. So it said that I am writing the names of those people who love God. So, and is mine one? Said Abbeu. So what Abbeu asked the angel, that if his name was there on the list. What was angel's reply? Nay, not so. So the angel said that it was not there. And with that, Abbeu became little upset, disappointed. But still, he spoke politely. It is written, but Abbeu spoke more low, but cheerily still. That means more low. Why? He was upset, disappointed. But still, he spoke very politely with low, soft, pleasant voice to the angel. And what he requested, I pray thee, then write me as one that loves his fellow men. So what he said, that In that case, please write down my name as a person who loves his fellow humans. So this is the third part of the poem. So I have completed the first stanza. So in next video, I'll give you the explanation of the second stanza or the last stanza, this last four lines, and what message it conveys, that also we will discuss a little bit. So thank you.